enable.
Hello and welcome to Decoding Business Growth Season 3. I'm your host, A.B. Ravi. The NBFT space is seeing lots of action, and the way the market is lapping up IPOs of these companies, it is a clear indication that the country's consumption-driven economy is on a high growth trajectory. With money easily available, we are seeing rise of new class of entrepreneurs. Today, more and more people are becoming entrepreneurs. One such company which is providing lifeblood to the MSME is the Delhi-based Hero FinCorp, a subsidiary of Hero Group's flagship company, Hero Motor Corp. This company was set up in 1991 to take care of the needs of Hero Motor Corp's dealers and vendors. Clearly, the company's initial role was to support the core manufacturing operation as the Munjals concentrated on their money spinner business, Hero Motor Corp. But 5 years back, things changed as the mantle of this company fell on the third generation family member, Abhimanyu Munjal. The foreign educated Abhimanyu had global exposure and he took to this company like a duck to water. He put life into this dormant company by recasting the business. Result, between 2012 and 2017, the company's loan book has zoomed from 300 crore rupees to 11,000 crore rupees. Now, this company is on everybody's radar, the family, banks, PE players and consumers. Take a look at Hero FinCorp story. It may give you lessons of how to convert a dormant company into a money spinner.
To be honest, even with all the necessary documents in place, it is still not easy getting a loan from banks or NBFCs quickly. The whole process can take anywhere between 4 to 5 days or even more in the case of complications. While technology has made a difference by making the process transparent and easy, there is still a long way to go before loan applicants can feel at ease. But there is one exception to this norm, a company that is actively seeking to ease the whole process by keeping the needs of the customer at the very core of its objective. With heavy investments in technology and people, the Delhi-based Hero FinCorp has managed to put in place capabilities that allows it to disburse loans every 30 seconds. And the result is for all to see. In the last 5 years, its loan book has zoomed by 36 times, from 300 crore rupees in 2012 to 11,000 crore rupees in 2017. The credit for this impressive performance goes to Abhimanyu Munjal, the grandson of the late founder BML Munjal. Abhimanyu's modern age approach and ideas have changed the landscape of this once dormant company. Today, Hero FinCorp's headquarters are buzzing with activities and the mood is upbeat as the company has enlarged its scope of activities. Earlier, it used to provide loans for two-wheelers. Now the portfolio has been expanded to include used car financing, loan against property, SME and personal loans. Established in 1991, Hero FinCorp is part of the country's fastest growing company, Hero Motor Corp, a dominant player in the two-wheeler sector. Initially, the company was called Hero FinLease and was set up to finance the needs of the vendors and dealers of Hero Motor Corp. Since it was into captive financing, it employed only two people who operated out of the finance department of Hero Motor Corp. For Munjals, the two-wheeler financing was not a focus area. It was one of the many services they offered to keep their customers engaged. With not much focus, its loan book averaged around 300 crore rupees every year. The turning point came in 2012 when the 29-year-old Abhimanyu Munjal, younger son of the late Raman Munjal, entered the scene. Abhimanyu, a graduate from the University of Warwick and American Intercontinental University, London, worked for a few years with foreign banks like Citi, ABN AMRO before joining the family business in 2007. Realizing that the manufacturing didn't excite him much, he decided to take over the finances arm, Hero FinLease, and turn it around. The family was more than happy.
I've always been keenly interested in financial services.
you know, after my schooling and graduation, I went to, I worked with Citibank for a year and ABN AMRO for a year and a half. That's when I decided that this is what my passion is and this is what I want to do.
Abhimanyu's enthusiasm saw the Munchals infusing 100 crore rupees by way of equity into the company. Thereafter, it was rechristened as Hero FinCorp to have a similar identity with its flagship company, Hero MotorCorp. Besides, Abhimanyu rejigged the business so as to increase their offerings, leverage synergies, and provide easy access to finance. To put his plans into action, he handpicked 12 key people who worked closely with him.
Over the years, our company has evolved. Our products have evolved. When we started, we only went to the low-hanging fruit, which is two-wheeler finance. And then in 2013, I realized, am I doing justice to the mandate of diversification? I said, no, I'm still only linked and still only doing Hero. So that's when we said, let's focus. We did another planning exercise. And let's focus on two clear themes in the company. One would be consumption. Second would be SME. In consumption, we believe the man on the street is our customer, and we would like to cater to him across the life cycle. We get him very, very young in two-wheelers. Can we give him a used car? So that's the new product that we have launched. We'll upgrade him in 2 years, build a credit history with us, go to a used car. Can we give him a consumer durable? Can we give him a personal loan? So in consumption, we want to cater through every demand of the customer's life cycle, and the product offering, the new products that we get into, will be dictated by the customer, not by us. The second focus was SME. SME, we saw, again, we identified some low-hanging fruit and some synergies with Hero Moto. The supply chain was very large, and we said we can play in that supply chain. So we set up a supply chain finance business. We set up a mortgage business. Because I think 2013, the flavor of the year or the flavor of the month was loan against property. There was no rationale to get into it. It was a business which was growing. We believe, and I believe, this is a very good product since in a longer run, you'll see property prices rise and the loan will be amortizing down. So it's a completely secured product. So we diversified. Today in SME, we have three verticals with three parallel teams, which is pure SME machine loans and supply chain, loan against property, and emerging corporates, which deals with larger corporates.
Besides expanding its offerings, the company also focused on serving the underserved market of rural India. And for this, it built a strong network of 2,400 plus touch points in 1,000 cities, from Jammu in the north to Nagarkoil in the south, and from Bhuj in the west to Tinsukia in the east. All these efforts were complemented by advertising and marketing. For instance, it launched a new campaign, Karo Khwabo Se Ishq, across TV, radio and digital platforms. The campaign resonated well. Soon the company saw a big draw of first-time loan takers. Today, 75% of its portfolio consists of first-time loan takers.
As we are going forward, we have experienced that almost 70% or more than 70% customer don't have any credit history. We have our erstwhile data available also. So we have some sort of advantage in that which we are working on. And that data is playing an advantage to us to devise an underwriting strategy which will help us to facilitate a credit to the customers who do not have a credit history with them.
What's even more interesting about Abhimanyu's plan is betting big on technology, which has enabled the company to bring in transparency, faster dispersal, and adopt an ultra-lean model, keeping so as to keep the cost of operations minimal. Evidently, Abhimanyu's strategy of capitalizing on Hero's brand, focusing on the rural market, and investing in technology has yielded dividends. Witness this. The company's revenue has jumped 20 times, from 70 crore rupees in FY 2013 to 1,331 crore rupees in FY 2017. Likewise, profit rose 7 times, from 19 crore rupees to 130 crore rupees during the same period. Equally impressive is its net NPAs reined in at 1.7%, whereas net interest margin has been in the vicinity of 6.5 to 7%. clearly, Abhimanyu Munjal has proved his mettle. The company is growing from strength to strength. On that note, it's time for a short break. When we come back, CNBC TV18's AB Ravi chats up with Pritish Kandoi of ICICI Securities to understand the rise and rise of Hero FinCorp. Stay tuned. Welcome back. In a short span of 5 years, Hero FinCorp has been able to de-risk its business by broadening its offerings. Today, two-wheeler loans constitute 31% of its total advances, while SME loans constitute 32%, loan against property 22%, bill discounting and inventory funding at 12%, and other retail loans at 3%. A charged-up Abhimanyu plans to grow the loan book to 35,000 crore rupees in the next 3 years. Is that possible? To understand the DNA of Hero FinCorp, CNBC TV18's AB Ravi spoke to Pritish Kandoi of ICICI Securities, and this is what he has to say. Take a look.
Pritish, welcome to the show. Pritish, I begin by asking you, what's your take on Hero FinCorp, given the fact this underserved segment is seeing a lot of competition?
So, Ravi, if you see both the SME credit and the consumer credit, which are the key areas in which Hero FinCorp is operating, are highly underpenetrated in this country. If I have to quote you certain numbers, the lending per capita in India is as low as $800-$850 per person. If you look at consumer credit, this number would be 1/4 of this. If you look at globally, some of the developed market like US, the borrowing per capita is as high as $50,000-$60,000. If you look at SME credit, 50-60% of the SMEs are self-financed or borrow from informal sources. The lending gap being spoken about is as high as 10 lakh, 12 lakh crores. So the market opportunity is huge. If you see historically, the players were not innovative enough to offer customized product offering to these segments. They were complacent in terms of reaching out. And there was not much customer focus and service standards, which left a lot to be achieved. In this context, Hero FinCorp has identified certain niche areas where they have an edge. Now, there are two parts to that. One is innovative product offering around the SME and the corporate credit business. And second is operate in the customer segment, which they understand very well. Okay. Now, the parent Hero Motor is the largest two-wheeler OEM with over 5 decades of customer experience in this area.
So, if I were to ask you, what sets the company apart from vis-a-vis competition?
Ravi, I would say three things which comes to my mind. One is people. The other is vision, and the third is the brand legacy. Now, Abhimanyu is a young, dynamic, and ambitious leader. Yeah. He has created a sizable enterprise in the last 3-4 years. His management team is one of the best in the markets. They have all come from reputed lending organization. Now, one thing we have to remember in financial services, that to create a sustainable business, it has to be created over the years across the cycle. Therefore, the longevity and of the management team plays an important role. The second thing is the vision. I really find them innovative and disruptive in their orientation. They want to challenge the existing way of doing things. Look at the slogan. We want to be next gen ultra lean credit champion in lending. And the third is, I think, the brand legacy. Now, Munjal family is one of the leading business groups in this country. Yeah, Hero brand been around for over 5 decades. So the brand evoke trust. This makes them responsible. Therefore, whereas for competition, customer centricity, you know, may be a matter of choice, but for them, it's given the brand legacy.
So you talked about ultra lean model. They have used the ultra lean model to keep the cost low, yet grow the business from 300 crore to 11,000 crore. I'm talking the loan book in last 5 years. How did they manage to do that then?
I think initially they figured out that there is a huge ecosystem of Hero Motor, dealer, distributors, customers around which they can create a sizable lending business. And they did that over the next few years in terms of creating a market share in two-wheeler financing and SME credit, which is the dealer-distributor segment. Sure. Having achieved critical mass in these two segments, they took a life cycle approach to the customer requirements and expanded into synergetic product categories like used cars, loyalty loans, LAP, SME credit, and going forward, they are looking at mortgages and consumer durable financing. Now, as they were expanding into newer products, they approached it in terms of using mobile-led analytical and tech tools and a centralized setup which help them scale rapidly and yet process a lot of volumes. So, for example, they've been processing like a loan every 30 seconds. They have a capability to process 100 lakh loan applications every month. Okay. And because they did not have any baggage, they managed to create a lean cost organization around the business.
The Abhimanyu now has a vision to grow the company to 35,000 crore loan portfolio by 2020. Here is looking of entering the housing finance space and also looking at inorganic growth. So given this backdrop, what's the outlook for the company?
I think, Ravi, the team has set a high standard for themselves. Given that they have put out in public their target for FY20, which is 3 times from here, clearly mean that the team is serious about it. At the same time, they have high conviction in terms of achieving it. If you see historically, they have grown over 30 times in the last 3 years, although on a smaller base.
Yeah.
But they have demonstrated that they are capable of managing growth.
Okay, very well put, Prithish. Thanks a lot for being on the show.
Thanks, Ravi, for having me here.
Well, that was investment banker Prithish Kandoi's perspective on Hero FinCorp. On that note, it's time for another short break. On the other side, we take a look at the road ahead for the company. Welcome back. Hero FinCorp seems to be on a roll. Its strong parentage, good financials and AA+ rating has attracted a host of private equity players. In September 2016, Chris Capital invested 570 crore rupees, followed by Credit Suisse with 132 crore rupees. And to show their commitment, the Hero Group has invested 300 crore rupees.
And if you look at Hero, they're only, when we invested, about 6,000 crore balance sheet. And right now, even as we speak, they're about 11,000, 12,000 crore. So there's very, very large market opportunity to scale up in retail finance. From a distribution network in India, they're unparalleled. Today, I mean, they already have 6,000, Hero Motor Corp has 6,000 dealership points or touch points in the interiors of India. It's a very rural product reaching to the, you know, to the masses. And clearly that distribution network is unparalleled and therefore, again, is something that can scale up quite rapidly. And then finally, I think their cost of funds on the liability side is amongst the lowest in the industry, even lower than competition, the larger competition that I talked about. So, you know, I remember clearly even when we were going through our investment committee process, people asked me the same question, what is it that singularly, you know, attracts you about this company? And I said, look, distribution network, but also at their cost of funds, the market opportunity is almost infinite for Hero FinCorp to grow. So that's really what appeals to us.
Now, with the company well capitalized and its investment in technology has created a strong backend that has made it possible to disburse loans every 30 seconds. To make this possible, it has an army of 3,700 plus employees. With the main business firing on all cylinders, Abhimanyu is now working on a blueprint to take the company to the next level. It has recently secured a license to enter the housing finance business space. Besides, it is also aiming at growth via the acquisition route.
In terms of loan book, market share, geographical presence, and NII, we have a vision which is 2020. We have a vision to go to 35,000 crores of asset size. This will happen not only by increasing geographical presence, because I believe we are already at, you know, the length and the depth of the country. Today, I'm in every state, even the Northeast, even Bihar. But it will come with adding new products. We are going to be launching home loans. That will play an important role to reach this number of 35,000 crores or $5 billion. And in 2020, we want to make this business profitable. I won't want to comment on NII, but we want to make a $5 billion company making at least 2 to 3% ROA.
In sum, the vision of the late BML Munjal was to let the third generation of the family build 3 to 4 large companies that could match up the size of its flagship Hero Motor Corp in the next 15 to 20 years. It is a very forward-looking vision that could catapult the entire group into the Super League, and in the process, make Hero FinCorp a blue chip in the making.
Well, Abhimanyu Munjal has won a well-deserved place under the sun for steering the company into a fast growth track. With that, we come to the end of this 9-episode journey of Decoding Business Growth Season 3. I hope you all like the series. I and my team certainly enjoy tracking the stories of the entrepreneurs and their journeys, which are so inspiring and compelling. Also, there were powerful lessons from each entrepreneur we featured on the show. We'll be back with Season 4 with more such fascinating stories. On that optimistic note, it's time to say goodbye from our entire team that includes producers, cameramen, video editors, studio head, graphic artists, voiceover artists. Thanks for watching CNBC TV18.